Hi, Peter here from URender. In this video, I will show you how to create HDR environment maps using a spherical camera. There are a lot of HDR packages out there, but sometimes you need specific color values or reflection planes, so it's really helpful if you know how to create them by yourself. The good thing is that you don't need to create very complex scenes if you use the HDRs as an environment map for diffuse and specular illumination. In fact, in this case, less is more. So I will start with a simple disk for a floor and assign a simple gray material. Now I create a camera with an URender camera tag assigned and set it to position 0. Go to the Spherical tab and check Enable. Depending on what kind of HDR map you need, you can change these settings, but the defaults fit very well for my needs. Start URender and move the camera upwards to see the ground disk. Next, I create a plane that will act as an emissive light source, parent it under a null object and position it. This will act as my main light source and I set it to a warm color. Don't be afraid to set the emissive strength to a high value. After duplicating the null object, repositioning it and getting a backlight, I will set a colder color. The next steps in the render settings are very important. First, set your output resolution to a 2:1 aspect ratio, for example 4K. Then set the output format to HDR 32-bit. In the URender settings, you have to deactivate tone mapping, otherwise you will lose dynamic range in your map. If you want to use bloom, you will notice that there occur some borders in the render result. You can get rid of them by increasing render resolution overscan values. Now let's check our map how it works in a scene. Render it to the picture viewer and save it. Here is a scene that is lit by two spotlights and all materials are set to very rough diffuse gray ones. Just load your HDR as global map in the environment render settings. We have defined diffuse and specular illumination and also some lighting from the bottom that is caused by our floor disk. I will add some more elements to our map now. Of course, I could duplicate the current emissive planes, but I show you a faster way how to fill areas except using cloner objects. Just create a sphere and set it to hemisphere. Scale it up that your emissive planes are inside it. Then create a new material and a layer in the emissive channel. Create a noise shader and set it to cell noise. duplicate it, adjust the colors and the seed, and then set multiply for blending. I set the emissive strength to a high value, but decreased the gamma to a very low value, so that we get a good balance between very bright and dark squares. Assign it to the hemisphere, and by rotating it, you can control if you want to have it affecting the entire sky or being more defined from one side. Let's see the difference in our test scene. That's all. Of course, you can create much more complex environments and use textures from real light sources and so on. But as you see, you can also get nice results with the most basic and easy setup possible. Thanks for watching.